actually the whole exposure about the aesthetic surgery and everything started, and doing their jobs well would be to start being non-judgmental about things.
True.
The basis of medical practitioner.
So I would like to show you a few pictures of Miley Cyrus, so you can give us a take on that. Okay, so
Rhinoplasty. Definitely a rhinoplasty. Yeah. And she looks quite different. Especially in the Grammys, I was also, shocked.
Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Ankita Jawanjal. I am a plastic surgeon and currently I am pursuing my plastic surgery aesthetic fellowship at SB Aesthetics Gurugram. It is an advanced training in aesthetic surgery which I am currently doing. Today we'll be doing a podcast with Dr. Shilpi Badani, who is my mentor and the founder director of SB Aesthetics Gurugram, India.
Hi, Ankita.
Hi ma'am, how are you doing?
I'm doing well, and it's a pleasure to be on this podcast with you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. So today, ma'am, I would like to ask you a few questions regarding your journey in the field of plastic surgery and aesthetic surgery and how you progressed in your career. So starting with a few basic questions, ma'am, where did you pursue your MBBS and MS General Surgery from?
So my journey into medicine started with my MBBS at SCB Medical College, Cuttack in Odisha. And after that, I've pursued my master's in general surgery from BHU Varanasi. And once I completed my master's, I went for a senior residency in SUPGI Lucknow. After spending a year there, I pursued my MCH in plastic surgery from Safdarjung Hospital in Delhi. So my fellowship in aesthetic surgery was in La Clinique Montreux. And there, actually, the whole exposure about the aesthetic surgery and everything started. And I was always interested in aesthetic surgery. So that completed my educational journey, really.
Okay, ma'am. So how would you describe your aesthetic surgery fellowship at La Clinique? How was it and what procedures did you see during that time?
Oh, I mean, it was a great time spent, actually. And my mentors there were Dr. Michelle Full, who was the founder of La Clinique, and Dr. Serge Lee Yu. And Dr. Full was really into facelifts and blepharoplasties. I also saw a lot of body procedures with him. And Dr. Serge was, again, specialist of breast implant surgeries and, again, body contouring as well. I saw a lot of non-invasive work being done there as well. So there were dermatologists in the clinic who used to do lasers, and Dr. Fulk used to do a lot of fillers. So, you know, all in all, it was a very wholesome experience that I had.
So you had quite a lot of exposure to both surgical as well as non-surgical procedures.
Yes.
So which one would you describe as your favorite surgical and non-surgical procedure during that time or afterwards also?
So, I mean, during that time, my favorites would be two, definitely facelifts and breast implants. So,
okay.
And the numbers were huge, actually. Right. And I had this experience of being the first assistant and, you know, really being into the things when you were operating as a first assistant, you know, seeing the post-op, pre-op, everything. So, it was a good time spent.
Great, ma'am. So, coming to the topic of aesthetic surgeries, so a lot of people are very inquisitive about aesthetic surgeries and plastic surgeries in general in celebrities.
Hmm.
So a common question which is asked to all of us is, when you look at a person, do you critically analyze their faces or their features? And, you know, you think, okay, she might have got this done or that done. So what is your take on that?
Well, I think, you know, as an aesthetic practitioner, you tend to notice things that perhaps a layman wouldn't notice or even other doctors wouldn't notice. So yes, we do notice things. But I think the basis of a medical practitioner doing their jobs well would be to start being non-judgmental about things.
True. True.
So that's very important. Sometimes it happens that a patient walks into the office and you see something, and you perhaps think that they may have come to you for this, but the issue that they tell you is totally different from that, you know?
Right.
So it happens ever so often, you know? And you must have noticed this too. So I remember in our initial consults, you said that, Oh my God, I thought that, you know, this patient would be inquiring about this, but to my surprise, it isn't. So yeah, it happens ever so often. But I think as medical practitioners, we have to be empathetic.
Right.
And we have to be non-judgmental. And it's, you know, I, for one, I would definitely not suggest a procedure to a patient. If it doesn't bother them, I won't speak about it. I mean, they will not hear it from me that, okay, you know, why aren't you doing this? Okay. You know, why are you thinking about this? Why aren't you doing this?
Yeah.
So, you know, it's not our job to point out their flaws.
True.
It's our responsibility to, you know, work on the weaknesses that tell us that, okay, doctor, I want this improved. So could you help me with that? Sure, we can, or maybe we can't. But, you know, as medical practitioners, we shouldn't ever, ever point out flaws of patients. And nothing is a flaw really.
Right. Yeah. Okay, ma'am. So coming to the topic of celebrities. So I would like to show you a few pictures of Miley Cyrus before and after.
Okay.
So we'll take a look at what procedures she might have got done. And so you can give us a take on that. Okay.
Okay, bring it on.
Okay, ma'am. I'll show you some photos of Miley Cyrus before and after. So you can take a look at them and let us know what you think about them.
Okay, I hope you have analyzed this too and you have your list ready. Okay, so let's start. Oh my God, okay. The eyes, definitely.
Definitely.
You know, yeah. So blepharoplasty, definitely. And I would say, I think I saw a picture of hers where even in the younger days, a little bit of eye bags were also visible. So I would say upper and lower blepharoplasty.
Definitely.
And coming down to the cheeks, she's lost a lot of weight recently.
Hmm.
Did you see her in the Grammys?
Yeah,
I saw her. She's lost a lot of weight. So perhaps due to the volume loss, she's done some cheek fillers. Could also be fat grafting. We don't know. But yeah, something for the cheeks. Rhinoplasty. Definitely a
rhinoplasty.
Yes. And lip fillers. She also had a gummy smile.
Yeah,
previously. And for that, she could have done some filtered Botox to bring the gummy smile down.
Right.
And her chin was quite, you know, triangular earlier. Yeah. And now I see that it has widened. And she doesn't have so much of excess skin. So I wouldn't say that it's just aging. Definitely a chin implant, maybe. An extended chin implant, extended and artificial chin implant. Buccal fat removal, of course.
100%.
110%, yes. Buccal fat
definitely.
Removal. And jawline was pretty good and it still continues to be good. And even weight loss makes the jawline prominent. Yeah, and eyebrows could be makeup or microblading.
What about an eye lift, a brow lift?
Lift, maybe not. But you know what I don't like about her look now, I'm sorry if I have to point this, but I would definitely think that she should get some filling of the upper eyelids done, because now she looks quite hollow. She had quite a nice, you know, fat under the eyelid, and that makes, you know, one look youthful. So she's sunken now. So definitely, I mean, yeah, so a long list of changes, really. And she looks quite different. Especially in the Grammys, I was also shocked, as so many people were.
True.
So especially, the buccal fat removal definitely
drastic
could have been avoided, I think. Right. And a lot of changes also could be due to weight loss. Could be Ozempic, could be diet, exercise. But so there's your list.
Thank you so much.
I hope it meets with your list as well. I mean, does it... do you have some other changes that you've noticed in her?
No, ma'am. I think you've covered all the areas, right from the head, like beginning from the eyes, to her nose, to her lips, to her chin, to her jaw. So I don't think we have left out any part on the face.
Okay, so then that means I passed the test.
Okay, ma'am. Wonderful. Thank you so much for a comprehensive assessment of her face. So we'd like to end the podcast here. Thank you so much, ma'am, for your time.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure. Thank you.